As we inch closer to the midway mark in the regular season, the Heisman race is beginning to come into focus. And two of the names near the top, very familiar to Big Ten fans, Ohio State's JT Barrett and Michigan's Jabrill Peppers. Now, Peppers, while primarily a defensive player, making a mark offensively as well. He had 74 yards and 2 touchdowns against Rutgers, not to mention a punt return for a touchdown that was eventually called back. He's dynamic, extremely versatile, but could still be a tough sell for the Heisman. The last primarily defensive Heisman winner was his fellow Wolverine, Charles Woodson. Jim Harbaugh making his case for Peppers.
I'll let you in a little secret. That run he made, this, the one touchdown he got in on, where he's bootlegging out to the right, was a throw. And there's nothing he can't do. It's the darndest thing I've ever seen. My humble opinion, I believe that we're looking at a Heisman Trophy winner and candidate.
All right then, Ohio State's JT Barrett has been in the Heisman conversation since game one, and each week he just adds more to his resume. He now has half a dozen 100-yard rushing games and 86 career touchdowns, just 2 shy of becoming the Buckeyes' all-time leader. And the Heisman voting history is on the side of Barrett. Heisman winners broken down by position. 33 of the winners have been quarterbacks, 43 running backs. Just 1 defensive back in there. For more on the Heisman discussion, let's go back to Mike and Robert.
Thank you, Jillian, and we want you to get involved with this section of our show as well. Go to btn.com/vote and chime in right now on our Dairy Queen fan poll. Who is more likely to win the Heisman Trophy? Is it JT Barrett or is it Jabrill Peppers? Ray, let me go to you first. Who would you vote for there and why?
Oh, my God, Mike, you're killing me going first. I thought you were going to go to Robert because, number one, I'm a quarterback-minded kind of guy. I think JT Barrett is sensational. The way he runs that offense is spectacular. But on the flip side, you talk about Jabrill Peppers, what doesn't he do? Defensively, great at putting pressure on the quarterback. Punt returner, he's sensational. Kick returner, unbelievable. Now we're seeing him on offense, you know, so I would say, you know, I want to say JT Barrett, and, you know, the other reason is Jabril's from New Jersey, so I would love to see a Jersey boy win the Heisman Trophy. But this is, Robert, I would say this is a pretty tight race right here.
It's a tight race, but as we know, Ray, quarterbacks are the most important players on the team. They're the smartest. They're the best looking. They're the best athletes.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Everything. But seriously, offensive players win the Heisman Trophy more often because it's called or it's defined as the most outstanding player in college football. And that usually correlates to overall stats. It's not just going to be stats spread around. Yes, you had some tackles for loss here. Yes, you had a sack there. It's your ability to impact the game. And a quarterback is going to impact the game just by the nature of the position. Last week against Indiana, only 93 yards passing for JT Barrett, but he ran for 137 yards on 26 carries. That's a huge workload. So I think his ability to run the ball, to throw the ball, almost 20 total touchdowns. He has a much better chance, in my opinion, to win the Heisman.
Well, Ray, isn't that a fair way to look at it, too? Because just the amount of opportunities Barrett will have to touch the ball in any game because of his position makes it so much harder for Jabrill. He'll still get a handful of opportunities, but there's less wiggle room for him to screw up or just have an average play.
Oh, I agree with you 100%. And Robert, you couldn't have stated it better. I mean, the quarterback is good looking, and he's definitely the guy that makes all his decisions. But again, when you look at JT Barrett, you know, I mean, the guy has his hands on the ball. And when you talk about quarterbacks, you also have to talk about that's the last line of defense for your offensive coordinator. No matter what play you call, that quarterback has to get you in the right play, and there's no one better than JT Barrett. And Robert's right, too. He's not just a throwing quarterback. I mean, the way he runs the football is exceptionally well, and the fact that he has his hand on the ball every single play Ohio State has the rock on offense definitely puts him, you know, as the front runner. But, you know, like I said, I know Robert's an Ohio State guy. That's all good with me. I'm a Jersey boy, so, you know, if I had a vote, I'd have to go the other way.
You're going to go with a vote already? Even with the stats the way they are today, you would go with Jabrill Peppers?
No, absolutely not. I mean, if I was going to be a true professional, it would definitely be JT Barrett. I mean, but again, you're seeing Jabrill Peppers put in more situations on offense, which I think is only going to help him out.
Yep.
Well, apparently our fans are not true professionals because they went with Jabrill Peppers, 61% to 39%. And I will say this in favor of Jabrill. Harbaugh knows about PR, right? He knows how to get attention. And having a Heisman candidate is a lot of PR. I wouldn't be surprised as if this gets down into November, we start seeing even more and more of Jabrill Peppers running the ball on offense just so he does get a chance to put his name in the papers there.